York. I got cross-trained to communications. I forgot what the number MOS was, but I got cross-trained communications, which was, I think, even easier because you send a communication truck, basically, and just wait. Because when I was in the military, there was no war, okay? I'm a little older. I was in the military from 86, 88. No wars, no issues. Gulf Wars hadn't started until 90, I believe it was. So there was no real issues in the world, so to speak. So we were stationed in Germany and just hanging out for the most part. I traveled around Europe and played basketball for all Army European team or anything else. I didn't have the traditional Army experience. I just traveled around and played ball, had a great time, and then got out and they gave me GI Bill money. So Memorial Day, that's a tough one because I'm not super patriotic, okay? I do love this country because I've been to other countries. This country's not perfect by any stretch of the imagination, but a lot of other countries are not perfect, and they're a lot less perfect than we are, okay? So for all of its negatives, I am still a fan of this country. I'm not a fan of all the people in this country. I'm a fan of the country in general. So Memorial Day to me is important because I understand what the military has gone through and what the military personnel do. And so it is important because if we didn't have the military that we have now, our country wouldn't be the same. And effectively, if you're a country with a strong military, you're always likely to be taken over or by a bigger country, okay? But that never would happen for us. So we need to understand the importance of Memorial Day is the people who serve, okay, and the value that they bring to us. And we have no idea what that real value was because we don't see behind the scenes. We don't see how the bird is cooked. We just enjoy our freedoms. So from that perspective, that's what I can think about.
All right, Mike.
I was in the military. I was in the Air Force. Served 6 years. Best branch there is, the United States Air Force. I told you I was a radio communications analyst specialist. How I got into that, I got tricked, to be honest with you, because I wanted to go into broadcasting out of high school, wanted to the military. I heard radio, they said, hey, this is radio, blah, blah, blah. Had nothing to do with radio. I was a 202 AFSC, it was my job description, 202. I got a top secret clearance, still don't know how I got a top secret clearance. They obviously did not talk to some of my cousins, especially my stepdad. They didn't talk to them. But like I said, I was at NSA for 3 years, and I cross-trained into communications once I got into it. I started doing television at NSA, behind the scenes, confidential stuff, talking about movies and things like that. So my military experience was pretty good. But at the same time, when it comes to Memorial Day, my thoughts on Memorial Day is this. Because of what we're going through right now, I think Memorial Day is important to remember people who have served this country and died for this country for the basic freedoms that we do have in this country. Right. You're trying to take a lot of things, even people who are domestically are trying to take a lot of our freedoms away right now. Obviously, you see the governor down in Florida, you see Trump trying to take over and trying to become more of a king or more of a monarchy instead of a democracy. So I think it's really important to remember those who have come before us, who have fought for our freedoms, freedom of speech, freedom of protest, and all those types of things. So I think on this Memorial Day, you should remember that and remember what it's for. And why this country is still, regardless of all its faults, still the best country in the world.
Absolutely.
Hold on 1 second. So, what's your thoughts about Memorial Day?
Well, first, my father was a Navy man, served in the Korean War. My brother just retired after 30 years, 82nd Airborne. He was stationed in Germany for the past 15, 20 years. He's probably been in every war since 82, Grenada, all the way up, and then my other brother was 82nd Airborne as well. So, like they said, I mean, I think it's very important to recognize the people that have served, that have lost their lives, that have fought for certain rights that we have and we take for granted. You know, my pop's not here no more, but he was a very proud Navy man. I mean, the Army Navy played, he was, you know, he was taking us up there, and he'd be rooting. Or tell those stories of, it sounded more like he went on like a 4-year cruise than anything. But I remember those stories loud and clear, and he was very proud of what he did. My brother told me, Master Sergeant, he's very, very, very proud. And, you know, I think Memorial Day is definitely important to, you know, it's like if we didn't have it should be all the time. It shouldn't just be Memorial Day. We should constantly be praising and being grateful for the people that serve this country. And like he said, when you've been all around the world, you do realize how good we have. There's other places, you know, that you may see. It doesn't look like a third world country, but it's compared to here, they are. And so, yeah, I think it's